They say that a captain always goes down with the ship. But what happens when the ship talks about getting rid of the captain? Prime Minister Tony Abbott faced a spill motion on Monday in Canberra, with Liberal Party members voting against a vote to open up options for a new leader and deputy leader.
The Liberal Party has dealt with the spill motion, and now this matter is behind us.
And what does Federal Opposition Leader Bill Shorten make of this?
Today we heard a desperate speech from a politically drowning man aimed at pleasing his MPs, but nothing for Australian families, Australian taxpayers.
Chief Government Whip Philip Ruddock announced the vote came in with 61% of secret ballot votes against a spill. This has raised speculation that 39% of Liberal MPs in the Federal Parliament were against Tony Abbott, with the chance of more uncertainty in the future.
Do I say that we can't all lift our game? Of course, we all do need to lift our game.
Communications Minister Malcolm Turnbull insisted he would not challenge the Prime Minister if the leadership positions were declared open, but he refused to comment on the change of date being brought forward from Tuesday to Monday.
The Prime Minister's decision, as you'd said, had been to hold the meeting on Tuesday, and you're right, I did praise him for that this morning. Subsequently, he's the Prime Minister, he's made a captain's call, and he's changed the date of the meeting.
The leadership spill came to light after two Liberal backbenchers from WA passed a motion of no confidence with the Prime Minister. West Australian MP Luke Simpkins announced on the afternoon of February 6 that he would move the motion, and it was seconded by fellow WA backbencher Don Randall. Party room criticism of the Prime Minister's performance came to a head after the Coalition lost government in the Queensland election, with a motion to spill the leadership.
Yes, it's been a difficult time for our country, but it's been a particularly difficult time for the government.
Prime Minister's decision to award a knighthood to Prince Philip was received poorly by the Australian electorate. A non-Australian with regal titles from England and Greece was given top honours over worthy contenders on Australia Day.
I think that in the media, you'd make a big mistake to pay too much attention to social media.
As the Liberal and Labor Party leaders reflect on their own political ambitions, if you close your eyes, you'll be led to believe that tomorrow was Election Day.
We want to end the disunity and the uncertainty which destroyed two Labor governments and give you the good government that you deserve.
And Opposition Leader Bill Shorten?
This is a Prime Minister who's only interested in hanging on to his own job.
The latest date for Parliament to expire is the 11th of November 2016, giving both parties time to put leadership spills behind them. Until next time. Darren McErlain reporting for Thursday Live, YassFM, Sydney.